Yes, once again, I'm starting out with the cough. So anyway, guys, hello, welcome back to another video on Florida Coasters. Now, you may have seen my Infinity War non-spoiler review. Now, for either of you guys who have seen it, I'm sorry, guys, I mean who's seen the movie before or aren't really into the Avengers and they're fine with spoilers, or just if you're fine with spoilers in general. I know if you're like a Marvel fan, you don't, and you haven't seen this movie yet, I know you probably don't need spoilers, but yeah. Yeah, and you probably don't want spoilers, but yeah, anyway. Anyway, let's get right into the video. Okay, so I just watched my Infinity War no spoilers review video. I'm not really someone who watches my own videos that much. Sure, every now and then I will like watch parts of them, but usually I don't watch my videos that much. I just watched my Infinity War non-spoiler review, and now I'm gonna do a spoiler review of it. So yeah, anyway, so I was shocked with how much deaths there were in the first place. A lot of people died. Personally, some people I know for sure died, like when Loki got choked to death by Thanos, and when Gamora definitely died when she got thrown off the cliff. Vision definitely died, but some of these characters either died or they may have disappeared to like a new world, like Spider-Man, he may have disappeared to a new world, and Groot and stuff, Black Panther, Okoye, whatever her name was, and yeah, and Doctor Strange, those, that, well, I mean, they might have died, because like Spider-Man said, Mr. Stark, I don't feel so good. Everyone's making fun of that quote, by the way. And, yeah, so, it may be because he doesn't want to go. I don't know if they died or disappeared. I'm assuming they died, but I think some of these characters are gonna come back to life. And, yeah, I think some of these will be gone for good, but a lot of these will come back to life. Like, Spider-Man Homecoming 2 was announced, so he's probably gonna come back to life. And yeah, I love that first battle against... Hulk and Thanos at the beginning. That battle was phenomenal. Love the battle between Thor and Hulk and Thor Ragnarok 2, which is my favorite MCU movie I've seen so far. Thor Ragnarok, phenomenal movie, have to go see it. And yeah, so overall, this is, you know, my thoughts on Infinity War. And the reason why I gave it a 9 out of 10 is because of just how many deaths there were. Like, I've been talking to like some people I know about it, and they said they enjoyed it, but they hated the end. And I was disappointed with how many deaths there were in this. And yeah, but they could have died. Some of them could have died, could have disappeared. Some of them died for sure. Only 3 of them, which are Vision, Gamora, and Loki, died for sure. But everyone else either disappeared or died. We don't know, though. We're probably going to find out in the next Avengers, and yeah. So, anyway, overall, I loved Infinity War. You gotta go see this movie. The reason why it's not my favorite MCU movie ever is because of all of the deaths. And yeah, of just how many people died in this movie. They could have disappeared. I don't know, though. Like I mentioned some other times in this video. And yeah, so overall, guys, this is my third favorite MCU movie behind Thor Ragnarok and Spider-Man Homecoming. And yeah, anyway, make sure to like, comment, subscribe. See ya!